Hi, I'm Bowling Otter.
And I'm Missy Sandwich.
Welcome to the BS.
The Bowling Otter Show.
Hello.
All right, it's time for the BS on the internet.
Oh my gosh, do I have a whole bunch of stuff.
What did we find on the web this week?
But you picked some stuff this week.
I did pick some stuff this week.
I know,
finally. I'm getting in on this.
I know, I was like, come on, because I will just fill this up. Like,
that's
for the next
happening.
10 years.
It's like, what are we going to do? It's like, I have less. Like, okay, I guess we'll
I'm
do
like,
your stuff.
I got stuff. You know?
But yeah, there's some stuff I wanted to look at too this week.
I know, for sure. So the first thing I have, now, I don't know if you guys are aware of the hydraulic press channel.
This is amazing.
And I mean, this just has taken up.
I hope you guys have seen this.
Okay, I really hope so too, because it's a guy, I guess he's Russian. I'm not sure where
he's
from.
He's got a ton
from.
Of subs. I mean,
yeah. Oh my gosh, 1.7.
1.7 million.
Oh, good for you.
So it's this person is not a small channel.
He has access to a hydraulic press, and he just squishes stuff.
Yeah.
And it's so, like, captivating and humbling. I
you
know
never know what's
going to
happen. Like, how's this one going to squish? Okay, this one's cool. You guys
yeah,
got to see this one.
Right.
He tries to crush 1,500 sheets of paper with a hydraulic press. This did not do it. I mean, after I thought about it, I kind of like thought it made sense, but this did not do what
crazy.
I expected to happen. I don't know
no.
what I expected.
I don't even
but
know.
But that's the best thing about this channel. You never know what you expect.
This is what
like,
got us like watching it.
Yeah.
We were like, oh my gosh.
And we are really nervous because this is going to be a really bad explosion.
Oh, really,
really
bad.
Really bad explosion.
Didn't just like punch a hole through the center. What happened? It like cracked. Oh, snappers.
Oh, knocked the camera off.
Look at that slow-mo action there.
Ooh.
Yeah, look at that. It like fragments.
Yeah, that's crazy.
What?
It looks like ceramic there.
Yeah.
But what's interesting is that, like, it occurred to me later, obviously, it's just wood.
Yeah, it's like, petrifying.
It's so, like, yeah, they're just pressing that much paper together that it becomes thicker blocks of wood.
Yeah.
Honestly, at that point. So
yeah.
That's crazy. Yeah. I don't know. This whole channel is filled with stuff like this where
yeah,
you just don't know how it would react, and it always does something
yeah,
you don't expect.
Like a geological process occurred.
Yeah.
Right
it's,
there.
It's
like
crazy.
It caused like
yeah.
this, it petrified it.
I'm not even sure if anyone's going to find this interesting. I think
I
it's
know.
Freaking fascinating.
I think it's really, oh my God, a hamburger. All right, a Big Mac. Here we go. Oh, this is going to be so gross. Yeah!
That is gross. It's disgusting. Oh my God.
Yeah, hamburger loose and the press wins.
Ah. All right.
I think it's not disgusting enough for you. Oh, look at him. He's stacking them all in there. Look. Here we go. What is this juice?
Why? Why would you...
I think this is going to be quite messy video.
Okay.
Yep, the extruder is now ready.
I like how he talks to you. He's like,
is he just,
hey!
Is he just, like, he just like decided not to do it because he's like, this is going to be gross?
Maybe, yeah.
Sorry. Oh!
It's like a party!
He's like, you're laughing.
Oh. Is he laughing at that
Cleaning
part?
Cleaning that up is gonna suck.
This other one that I found that I want to show everybody. What is Louis doing down there?
Louis got into the cabinet.
Look at his little tail sticking out. We have a cabinet over here, and he just kind of slipped his way in there.
Was
like, okay,
get away. Ground.
He knows it's late, and we should be going to bed.
Yes.
Anyway, but old people Facebook, you guys. How amazing. If you haven't seen it, it's a subreddit. I think it's its own website, maybe, but I'm going off of the Reddit. But off of the Reddit. But the old people on Facebook just crack me up. And everybody knows, like, somebody's grandma is on there. Or there's some kind
don't
of
get
like,
it, don't
they're
quite
not getting
understand
it.
How it works. Don't
oh
understand how they like the online social media interaction works.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's kind of comes it comes out like the most adorable ways.
I know.
And like kind of
like judgmental
and
racist
and, like,
as well.
Like really
like,
cringeworthy
oh
ways. All sorts of
I
stuff.
Know. Honestly amazing how much more I enjoy doing the dishes when I have two essays due on Monday. And if you don't do the essays, you may be able to make a career of it. Love you. Granny created the group. You want this bowl. Granny added you. Granny changes group's icon. Granny left. You're now an admin.
That's what she said. And it's just him and her. Do you want this bowl? Instead of just messaging, you created a group called Do You Want This Bowl?
Gosh. And look, the icon is a picture of a bowl.
That's actually kind of
she
creative.
She took the picture. Was like,
that's
they
the way
want,
they were like,
they
want this bowl right here? Do you want this bowl?
Aunt gave birth yesterday and Grandpa was very excited.
Okay. That's not Facebook, but that totally counts.
I think so. I think it's Grandpa. Just the whole like social media
okay.
Texting grandparents.
Okay.
Oh my
so?
Gosh. A photo of my fiance. Okay. How did I get so lucky? Because you're a very handsome, great guy.
Thanks, Grandpa.
That's cute.
Grandma, that's a rhetorical question.
That's really cute.
Answer.
That's cute.
But that's one of the adorable ones. Oh, it's amazing.
Oh my god.
I wish somebody loved me as much as this horse loves broccoli.
Okay. That's a lot. That's a bear and a cantaloupe, but okay.
That's a bear.
Wolf and a watermelon. Does everyone see it differently? I see wolf and watermelon. Is this about a dress? Oh my god.
Well, if it's all caps, wolf and a watermelon.
And a watermelon.
Everybody. It's wrong.
There's also some fried fish. Oh, honey, I know you're not fixing to get over my lane. That's hilarious. Oh, oops.
You're not fixing to get
fish.
Over him.
Oh,
my
honey,
lane.
I know you're not fixing to get over my lane.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
That's awesome. Oh, God.
Grandma's up to 8 stacked profile pic filters now. How far would she go?
Oh my really? God! Good for you. She likes a lot
like
of different
the
things.
Was it the flower border and the hearts around
and
the top
hearts
of
around.
It?
She's very busy.
And all the cats, the cartoon cats.
Oh my gosh, she's very, very busy. Oh. This lady.
So good. Magreso is supposed to be having a job interview. Is he there? Walmart. We hope your grandson did well. He didn't go. He was busy catching those pokebugs on his phone. Very upset with him.
Oh,
jeez.
Oh, my God. Oh, Phyllis.
Oh, Phyllis.
Poor Phyllis.
You just want your grandson to do well.
Now, you have to come with me on this journey for a minute because the other night, I got stuck and I roped you into it.
Yes. Quite,
you know when you go, you know when you go down like a YouTube hole and you watch some kind of random
this
video
whole series
about
is just
something.
Starting to be about YouTube holes. Basically.
I know, and I got stuck in this hole of this cockatoo that talks. And do any of you have a cockatoo? Have any of you
I
had a bird that talks?
I would love to know if any
talks?
Of you have a cockatoo. That
because
amazing.
Part of me thinks that would be really neat, but part of me thinks it would be like a nightmare.
Yes.
So have any of you had birds or whatever? I'm so curious about that because this one is like amazing. But like before I play this or show you this, look, I watched all the videos on the right. You see that? We went through the whole, granted they're very short.
Yeah.
But still, like I went nuts. But look at this bird, and it's subtitled, which is insane. All right, look at this. They're like playing a trick on this bird. Oh my God, you're on Twitter!
I gotcha. I gotcha. I gotcha. I gotcha.
Who's in there?
Okay. He just walks around the house. Just walks around the house.
Oh. It's surprising.
What was that?
Is it a bath ingredient?
Is it a
hairbrush? You see this thing go?
Yeah.
It's a hairbrush.
Oh.
Isn't that so weird? It's the bully drop. I like this.
Yeah,
I like this kind of like. All
right. Anyway. It's so funny. I mean, like, it's a little weird because it's like, it's just somebody making up words. See, it's funny because, like, I mean, it's just imitating syllables, you know, and like it comes together as weird combination of words that sound like it could be saying this.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's just funny. It's like, I don't believe it's saying any of these things.
No.
Like, it's saying some of it, but and a lot of these things are like a little weird. Crazy, but I think it's just hilarious. There's a cockatoo walking down the hallway just going like, back and forth between rooms or up and down. That's what I kind of mean, that like a week of that.
Did they just walk
be like, come on,
around
come
the
on.
House doing that though?
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's crazy.
But how funny would that be to walk around the steps and see like a little bird? Oh my god. I know.
I mean, that'd be really good. Because it would happen in the middle of the night. You know what happened in the middle of the night.
Oh, totally.
Like 3 o'clock in the morning, like, you'd be like, oh my god.
I'm bad rat.
Terrence.
Kind of creepy.
Terrence, go to bed.
Terrence the cockatoo.
Okay, and this is just excellent. Somebody wanted to buy a KKK march with a sousaphone.
And this is what stupid looks like.
And they just trolled the KKK.
It's funny, because those guys can F off.
Yeah, with everything that's been going on over the last couple weeks in the country, it's so nice. Look at that.
The KKK is just a whole level of stupid, and I just love that, like, the sousaphone thing is hilarious.
That's a great idea. I think the best one is the whoa, whoa.
Except for the person who's like narrating the whole time. It's like, shut up. You're not funny. The sousaphone's funny.
Yeah. Is it a sousaphone or a tuba?
I can't see it. I think the title of the video said sousaphone.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's a sousaphone.
Oh, it is a sousaphone.
Totally sousaphone.
Oh my god, that's the best idea.
I wonder how long he did this for.
Oh my god.
Like, how long did you do the whole time?
I don't know.
That would be hilarious.
But doesn't that have to be so irritating?
Oh yeah.
I would just be like, ugh.
Yeah, the whole time they gotta be like white knuckling. Like,
incredible. Okay, now I just saw this getting shared around this week, and it's a year old, but I was crying. It may replace my gorilla throwing grass meme. Look at this guy.
There's too many things to talk about here. The socks, the shirt, the wristbands, the dance,
but
obviously. The face. I mean, like,
oh my gosh, what's with the arms?
This.
I just like the whole I think I need to learn how to do this.
Everything about this is just like a cartoon. This is like a cartoon. And the face he's making the whole time. And then this guy.
Oh, he's got a buddy. Yeah. Oh, he's not as good at it as his friend is.
No, he gets better as
he's
it goes, though.
He's good. Oh.
Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is. What the?
I don't see.
And he's looking back.
Like, yeah, man. Oh, he's got a big beard. I didn't notice that last time. Oh my god, I saw this and I was like, look! It was one of those late night things. I was like,
yeah.
Like,
yeah, it was one of those. Look, there's people working at a house like next.
That is amazing.
Oh my god.
Look at that. Oh, look at the
there's people in Starbucks behind them.
Oh, they got another buddy.
There's people driving by.
Look at his little jacket. His little denim vest. Half vest.
Oh my god.
The dude's face in the front, though, with the big frown.
I mean, like, how did this start? How did they come up?
Probably started, like, just doing it in their house and just kind of getting around like that.
Somebody just, like, did it once to be funny and everybody died, and then they're like, dude, like, we need to make a video of you doing that. Because that's probably exactly what happened, because I love a freeze frame at the end. They couldn't have been that calculated. They had just been like, that was funny. keep doing that, and I'm going to make a video.
That is unbelievable.
That's ridiculous.
Oh my gosh, that makes me so happy.
Okay, so if you don't know, back in like the 80s, when WWE was WWF, it was a World Wrestling Federation.
Right.
And I think it was a World Wildlife, that's the reason
yeah,
they changed, I
that's
think.
Right.
But when it was WWF, and there was these crazy wrestling promos they would cut. Of just like, in, they would literally look like they were going insane. These guys are just going to
I
cameras.
I haven't seen them.
And they were like, they were all like really dramatized, but took themselves really seriously. I mean,
did
really.
Did they like rhyme and stuff?
Sometimes.
I can't believe
but there's like,
that I've never
some
seen
some of
these
are so insane, and Lissy has never seen them. And I and like I'm so glad she's managed to go this far to where we're going to record this, and you still haven't seen them because
okay.
I'm so anxious for you to see
I
this.
I did not even know,
you didn't
this,
know
was
this was
a thing.
Thing. I can't
I
wait to
so,
show you this.
I'm so I really am excited. So.
Okay, so
do
we're
you
gonna.
Know, do you know which ones you want?
Yeah, I do. I'm gonna
oh,
have to find
you
a couple real quick. I know some of them. I know some of them. Let me see here. Okay, this dude is a special kind of. I just hold on.
Okay, who is it?
The Ultimate Warrior. Okay,
I've heard of him. I didn't watch, it just wasn't on in my house.
I was in the capital from a place long from here, and I came here for one reason. To attack and keep coming. Not to ask, but just to give. Not to want, but just to send. Send the power of water down everybody's throat in the WWE till I become sick of it.
Oh,
well, you're gonna get sick of it because this freaking nature right here is just beginning to swell. And when I get big enough, brother, there ain't gonna be room for anybody else but me and all the warriors floating through the veins and the power of the warrior.
How
must I prepare? You must ask yourself. Should I jump up the tallest building in the world?
Okay.
Should I lay on the lawn and let him run over me with lawnmowers?
With the armpit
tassels. Should I go to Africa
tassels.
And let him topple me with raging elephants? Ah, you can feel it, dude. You can feel it. Load the spaceship with the rocket fuel. Load it with the warriors. In my final meeting with the gods from the heavens above, as they spoke to me and hit me with the power of the Ultimate Warrior, they told me, exit stage left, exit stage right. There is
when
no
was
place
this
to run.
On?
All the fuses and the exit signs have been burned out. With the command of my voice, I raised the level of the words to one that can't be reproduced.
What?
Take your claws into
wait,
my
wait audience. A minute, wait a minute. When was this on? When was this on that I didn't
I
see this?
I don't even remember. I don't even remember what channel it was on, but I remember being little and like flipping around and sometimes something like this would be on TV.
That,
like,
yeah.
It'd be...
Really? Who
yeah.
else? Who else do we
there's,
have?
There's a lot.
Give me like a couple.
Let's,
I want
to
get.
Let's go back. Let's
well
go back
rounded.
To the other page. Let's go back to the other because that was like the. Here we go.
He's got you. What do you think?
Well, first of all, if I were David Crockett and I were associated with Ric Flair, I'd do what I do each and every week, and I would say, yeah. Lay the gentlemen before you, we have the greatest wrestler of all time. We have a man that in his own modest way can tell you that last year he made $2 million.
Look at his gold chain.
Yeah.
Without a
and
lot of green
collar shirt.
Without practicing medicine, without owning a corporation, and without running for president, which is next on the agenda.
What?
The bottom line
oh,
is.
This is hitting a little
right
bit up here.
Oh. And
this is hitting me a little too close to home here, folks.
Dropout.
I was gonna say, like, oh, he's kind of like delusional,
yeah.
And like, everything's
from the
like, oh.
He was 15 years old, is the best wrestler in the world.
Was that next? Hold on, I gotta go back. Where was she?
She was just chilling.
Have him from the time he was 15.
Somebody
every
in the
woman,
like,
they're like, woman, a girl. Wait, what was your the one with the name that I thought was really funny?
Jimmy Superfly Snuka. Jimmy
That's
Superfly
it.
Snuka. There it is.
What?
There it is. Here we go. Here we go.
In a moment, our guest, ladies and gentlemen,
oh
will
God.
Be Superfly Jimmy Snuka, one on one with the Cobra
He's
Clutch
so
Specialist Sergeant Slaughter. What about it, Jimmy?
No, it just seems like that Vinny, that everybody just wants to cripple me somehow. Just seems like that somebody just want to put me out of professional wrestling. just seems like that they want to treat me like if I'm some kind of an animal. Seems like they want to take me in the back of some warehouse and try to treat me to teach me some lesson into my mind. Well, Sergeant Slaughter, you might be right in your way, but you got to remember one thing, brother.
Oh, no.
I am not in your category as far as the army way of thinking and knowledge of your mind. This man has got totally a different knowledge and a totally different thinking according to the way you think.
What?
The only thinking that we're going to do, brother, is right inside there. Don't you?
What?
240 pounds.
Like, what does that even mean? What did that mean? Like, what is that even? Hold
and
on.
It's just so crazy, but this is like, oh.
The warlord, he tangles with the superfly, Jimmy Snuka.
Oh, hello.
Warlord? Yes, brother. I know you like to go to that gym, and I know you like to work out, and I know you like to train that body to get yourself in top shape for any kind of action that you get involved in. Well, brother, let me tell you something, my man. I love to get in shape myself, and I love to work out. Woof, woof, woof.
Superfly.
He's like, another news?
Anyway.
What?
Here's the weather's going to be.
I like how he was just like casually working out before he started.
I love how seriously they take themselves.
Oh my gosh, they're like all sweaty. So wait, like this would be on during like the news?
No, it would be the show. They make it look like news.
Stacked against the Macho Man Randy Savage in WrestleMania 3. Hey, let me say it here. Let me say it out loud. And let me point to the president of the World Wrestling Federation. The Macho Man Randy Savage is not happy with your decision. Yeah, I am the cream in the World Wrestling Federation. And there is no doubt about it. Yeah, you mean Gene Okerlund. You know that I'm the cream of the crop.
Wait a minute, though, Randy. I've got to ask you very seriously. Do you blame Mr. Jack Tunney, the distinguished president of the World Wrestling Federation, for Ricky Steamboat being the Intercontinental Champion today?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. Outside interference here. In my moment of glory. Yeah, now I'm living in a nightmare. And I am the cream. And now, not only the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt must fall, but the World Heavyweight Championship belt. Because Hulk Hogan, yeah, I am the cream.
Yeah,
the cream of the crop, and there is no one that does it better than the Macho Man Randy Savage.
On balance, my
balance doesn't matter. I'm better than you are, yeah. And I'm talking to everyone in the World Wrestling Federation, and I'm even talking to President Jack Tunney. Yeah.
I'm on
my way.
Nothing's gonna stop me.
Nothing's gonna stop me.
You know, just out of curiosity, Randy, and I certainly don't want to diminish your tremendous God-given talents, but I'm very curious. I haven't seen Elizabeth lately.
Yeah, she's on the outside of the ring. Does she interfere in matches? Yeah. Nothing, zero, yeah. Pure athlete, yeah. And I've been, maligned from the top to the bottom.
He's getting me hyped.
The Macho Man Randy Savage. The cream of the crop. Nobody does it better.
See, the thing is, this is why people watch this, because you see that, you're like, that was fun, and then you get to watch him fight whoever he was complaining to, and like this big match, like the build-up, and then it's a personal thing once you get in there.
It's coffee creamer.
Oh man, I feel like if WWE was still like that, I'd watch it. I'd have to be like, I got it. Look at this. Hold on. We got Hulk Hogan.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a taste of it a little earlier on here on Saturday night's main event, when the madness met the mania. I am talking about Macho Madness and Hulkamania.
Oh my gosh,
two mega powers beating here tonight. Hulk Hogan, what is happening?
Well, you know me, Gene, we really don't know what we're dealing with here, man. And I'm just kind of a little worried about locking up here.
It's all right.
Because we just might blow the whole planet up, you know. Everybody knows that Hulkamania is
so
the strongest force
happened?
In this universe.
No!
This is what it was like?
Ring. No!
And I saw what the madness was all about. I realized there was a whole nother universe out there, a whole nother frontier.
This could be my new favorite thing. I kid you not. I think
I want to watch all of these. I want to watch them all. Oh, there's countless.
don't want to stay in a shack right now.
Spinning around. He like looks at the wall behind him. He's like, yeah.
Reckless abandon is what I used to be. Yeah.
Why are they so like wet? They're like glistening.
Because the whole time they're going,
he endorsed Macho Madness and gave me direction. Yeah. Reckless Abandon used to be, but direction now with the mega, yeah, the mega, yeah, the mega power, yeah. Mega power, yeah.
He keeps spinning around.
Can I be here for Halloween? I'm serious.
Can I be here for Halloween?
That would be amazing. That would be great.
I've never been better, yeah. Don't you worry about the hit over the head, man. I'm just worried about where we're going from here. Isn't this stratosphere, man?
And you. They shout at the camera.
It's like, and they have the guys in the middle.
The interviewer's back the whole time, like, yes, absolutely, sir. I completely take this seriously.
It's so aggressive.
And they always pick the smallest person they can to be the announcer. It makes them all look that much bigger. And lastly, Ethan and Hila.
The best YouTube
ACHU
victory
productions
to date.
Won their lawsuit.
Oh,
so I
want to
talk
gosh.
About that for a real quick second. For those of you who don't know, H3H3 Productions, a lot of you guys are fans, we're fans, and they were sued by someone whose video they watched and did a reaction video of. They always do their reaction videos. They watch somebody talk about it. They just have some fun on the internet stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's hilarious. I love the way
it's
they act.
Very funny,
they're really funny. It's a really creatively edited video. But even this particular video was just like one of their like B videos on their other side channel.
Just
talking about
this dude a year and a half ago
being really tasteless in some videos he made. And they were just talking about it. But even at the end of the video, they were like, yeah, but you gotta respect the guy. He works really hard.
Yeah, he has a good hustle.
It was kind
of
complimentary at the end of the day, and he sued him for defamation, for copyright infringement, for three different counts. I forget what the other one was. And this lawsuit been going on for a long time. Ethan and Hila decided to fight it instead of settle because they felt like it would be important to set a precedent for fair use on YouTube. And it finally came out that they won their lawsuit, which is incredible because it was costing all the money they had. Mm-hmm. They were going broke over it.
Yeah.
And a lot of people had to donate to help them afford it at all.
Yes, Philip DeFranco helped set up the whole thing for them.
It was a big deal.
Yeah.
But the fact that they won, the reason I wanted to talk about it is it's super important for YouTubers.
Mm-hmm.
They finally have legal precedent for fair use on YouTube.
Yes.
So now criticism, which there's so many videos on YouTube that are just critic videos and review videos that don't just watch things. They discuss them. They critique them and they have conversations about them. And what we found out now is that it's not an infringement of copyright.
Right.
And now we have legal precedent for it, which means that people who are getting sued in the future can now point to this as legal precedent.
Mm-hmm.
And it should really cut down on frivolous lawsuits and threats concerning it. And for copyright strikes, when they try to flag something isn't fair use, now you have legal precedent to challenge it. I'm sure you guys have heard all about copyright strikes on stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a huge, huge deal for what this really means for it. It's fantastic. So I wanted to share that. It's just really great news for the YouTube community
so
in general
amazing.
And very recent news.
Yeah.
So yeah, happy about that.
The guy actually tried to say that they're not film critics.
Yeah.
So they don't have the right to critique. Yeah. And they're like, what? Like everybody, like this is the internet, this is life, this is what everybody does. You know,
I mean, honestly, watching the videos
and all that stuff.
If he's like a filmmaker, they might as well be film critics
officially. Yeah,
I mean, because like we're all talking about a lot of stuff on YouTube. It's amateur stuff.
Right.
Which is the great platform for amateur stuff. Mm-hmm. You don't have to be professional. You don't have to be school.
Yeah.
You can just have it be a hobby and go do some stuff on YouTube. That's what makes it great. But this protects a lot of the people that do it.
Mm-hmm.
So congratulations to Ethan and Yellow HVHU Productions. And congratulations to all YouTube creators everywhere.
Yes.
Because this is a big deal for all.
For everybody.
Okay, guys. That was this week of the BS on the Internet.
Yes.
We had a lot of fun doing this. And hope you guys are liking it too. Let us know in the comments what you think.
Yes.
If you like this video, please support us on Patreon. Click like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, bye.
Bye.
Yes, there we go. Okay.
Okay, so now, do you want to hit that?
Yeah, let's hit it. That's it. Oh no, it just made that thing, throw up. It made that thing impossible. Okay.
Well, now we know what that is.
Well, we knew I was going to do something bad. We just had to find out.